the story of the stigmatization, the story of the broken hearts, the story of the broken relationships, the story of the broken marriages, story of broken hopes and dreams, and the story of death. That is the addiction in a nutshell. We never know how precious this gift of life is until we lose everything we have in our life, including our life sometimes. Ladies and gentlemen, please lend me your ears. I didn't come here to steal your affection, nor did I come here to play with your emotions. I just came here to tell the story of an old man who went to hell and came back alive to tell the story of the addiction. I am not an expert in this field of addiction. I am not even a professor. I am not a counselor. But I did MA, which qualifies me to talk on this very subject. I don't know what your MA is, but my MA is Master's in Alcohol Drinking. According to me, addiction is a ticking bomb. It's a ticking bomb for each and every one of us, whether we drink or don't drink, whether we play with substance or we don't. It is a ticking bomb for each and every one of us. Ticking bomb has a habit to get blasted. When that ticking bomb blasts, it blasts each and every fiber of that addict. Not only that, it blasts each and every fiber of whoever is around that addict. When that bomb is blasted, nothing is left out of that addict. It is gone up in the smoke. But when the dust settles, the story is left behind. The story of the stigmatization, the story of the broken hearts, the story of the broken relationships, the story of the broken marriages, story of broken hopes and dreams, and the story of death. That is the addiction in a nutshell. When addiction attacks us, it doesn't look at us at our status. It doesn't look at us whether we are minister, whether we are coolie, whether we are a middle-class society. It attacks us. When it attacks us. Our hardcore, everybody. Everybody has got susceptibility and vulnerability to become addict. When we, any one of us, if we wanted to become an addict, we have formula to follow. We don't just become addict all of a sudden. We have a formula to follow. When we start becoming an addict, your neighbors will shout at us, "What are you doing in the middle of the night? You are not allowing us to sleep." Will you stop? You will not stop. You are beginning to become an addict. You will keep drinking. After that, your neighbor stops talking to you. Will you stop? You won't stop. You will keep drinking. After that, you will lose your good friends, but your drinking friends, your bad friends, will remain with you till your money is gone. After that, your friends will also go. Will you stop? You will not stop. After that, if you have a job, you will lose your job. You still won't stop. If you have parents, they will throw you out of the house. You will still not stop. If you have a spouse, wife, or husband, they will throw you out. That is the very time you will hit the dustbin wherever the dustbin may be. At least from that dustbin, you have a comfort to beg the people. And if by begging, if you get money, you will still drink. If you don't get the money by begging, you will steal. You will manipulate the people. You will cheat the people to get the money to drink. Well, to introduce myself, my name is Jimmy Tsering. I am from Kurte, Lonchil, from Wambur, Wambur village, Chenkhar, Giok. My parents are both gone, but I have 6 sisters, 1 elder and 5 younger. I served in the army. I served in the army for 15 years, from the rank of second lieutenant till the rank of major. I was thrown out of army because of this beautiful drinking. I served in the army. Yes, I fought the war in 2003. I fought the war and won the battle for our country. But when I fought the battle with these bottles, I surrendered. I lost the battle of the bottles. But you have to know, all these onlookers, you have to know that nobody plans to become an addict. I have never planned to become an addict. But it just happened so. My parents must have never wished me to become a drunkard. Like when I was small, oh, little Jimmy, please grow up so that you'd become the biggest drunkard of all. Anzumbe, they must have never wished me. Teachers in the schools and colleges never taught me how to drink. Instructors in NDA and IMA never taught me how to become a drunkard. It just happens. If it has happened to me, it possibly could happen to each and every one of us here today. The vulnerability and susceptibility to become a drunkard is with each and every one of us. If you don't want to become them, please never play with that substance. If you're playing with that substance, you are already inside my boot, and my boot will take you to the places you never wanted to be, Imela. My boot will take you to hell and leave you there. My boot will never get you back. Coming back becomes your choice. And 95% of people like us will never try to come back, and they will never be back. Today I came here to tell you the tale of an old man, and that old man is me. I came back from hell and life to tell you the story of me. Everybody should know that this is a disease. Alcoholism is a disease. Drug addiction is a disease. It's a brain disease. You can Google it through. It is there, all over there. It is a brain disease. I don't want to, because I don't have time to tell you how this disease is got inside the person. But let me tell you, it is a disease inside a brain, which is chronic. Chronic means till we die, this disease remains with us. And it is relapsing in nature. And it is also called the progressive disease. Because progressive disease means today this one pack of drinks will be giving me a high, giving me a kick. But I keep on drinking this one pack for 5, 6, 7 months down the line. This same one pack is not giving me the kick. I have to graduate to 2 packs. That's what I'm telling progressive disease. When I was a soldier, there were my seniors who used to tell me, "Ani gachi mo dasho arzang di chaya tu mi shebe, ngazum tu me pegre re chiru re lu pegre re chungku limit be chebe." Let me tell you today, there is not even a single animal in this whole world who knows the limit of drinking. Nobody knows the limit of drinking, because it is progressive in nature. I don't know how my senior has done it. He said to drink it limit like him. But that very person has reached to rehabilitation 6 years before me. I don't know what his limit was. So if you think you are drinking limit-wise, please be careful. You are already following my footsteps. And my footsteps are not a good footsteps. It is a family disease. It's not only the drunkard that suffers. It's not only the addict that is suffering. His parents, his relatives, his brothers and sisters, they are suffering more than the addict, because addict is addict. They keep drinking and they don't know whether they are suffering or not, unless the drinks go out of his head. Then only when he realizes, that's the time when he goes through the painful phase of life. But when he was drunk, he doesn't know. His parents go through that. If there is one drunkard in a family, all those family members knows what is that addiction? Because they don't know how to deal with these people, what to do with these people. And they are going and suffering more than the addict. Even when that phone call comes from a new number, they are not being able to pick that call, thinking it must be from police. Maybe my drunken son is kicked out by the trucks. Maybe yachibin car ki thuko ta mo yachibin sampale chong ma joga yachibin drugs ki police ki mazu ga. That much suffering they go through. That is why it is called a family disease. Now we have stress on disease. If this addiction is disease, then I deserve treatment, not the punishment. Did I get any treatment? I was kicked here and there when I was in army. Wherever, when officers doesn't want to go, and they go up there, I become a dispensable officer in the RBL because of this addiction. It is my fault. It is everybody's fault. If my boss, if my commander knew that this is a disease, I think he must have given me a better treatment today. I think all those people who are watching today, they might know now that it is a disease. But those days when I was in my addiction, it is a different story. Nobody knew, including me. I didn't know it was a disease. So, since it is disease, please think that we are not mad. We are not bad. We are just sick. And treat us as a sick person. I try to stop this. I try to stop doing this alcoholism. Kadim chichi ta ni bemitsubela. Kachiye bete lang. Shabda jab de aate il. Cham jab de aate il. Ga be aate il. Mu be aate il. Kachiye bete il. Kadim chi shani ki. Kadim chi pa cham roe bera mitsubela. I tried everything. I have done more than 20 times. Did it stop me? It could not stop me. Army nale 10 times. Did it stop me? I was drinking more after that because there was no commander. I was doing it more because it is disease. Gachye beta tade berure de chanche mitsubela. I felt so much uselessness inside me. I thought this beautiful world would be much, much better without my existence. I went down onto the bridge and I jumped into the river and committed suicide. That's why I'm here in front of you. Chugi bamatu chugi phaleya tanga lokte yate theno ani be daru garilam kha hechi garilam kha talu chum chim bago chidula ai bagona josoman ya am chidu am dingal ta wa chen nyazu ma joilo joi bol nga nyazu ma jiam chuna nya mindu slap chi chang ye ga sen ye lo chang ji basho se dele darura chuin daru cha thu mela. Now see the power of this addiction. I wanted to tell you I can die, I can commit suicide to stop the drinks la. But when I came back from the Male River le yata log om dalu darura chang thungo bela, because my brain is not leaving me. My brain is attacking me. My brain, that addiction, has controlled my soul, my body, my mentality. Everything has been controlled by that addiction. And I have no control over me. Nga chang gachi bi thumo da na bale chang mi thum se mi disu gachi bi thumo da che ane bi punishment bi ni che na ani zum tim ke ni se sung da ta nga na bale thuna mi thum se yui la nga na bale thuna mi thum se nga gi yu da lu. Did I tell lie la? I didn't tell lie la. I meant it. But my disease is controlling me and I have no control over myself. That's why I drink it again. That is the power of addiction, and it's so, so very, very powerful. And at this stage, when I was drinking, I was not drinking to get high email. I am drinking to get normal. My life is abnormal without drinks. loya mitula da de yachibi tip nina disu ten anzum baby. I can't. And I have to drink if I have to get up and work. We are drinking at this stage not to get drunk, to get normal. So I told you the formula. The ma dustbin na he. Dustbin na he bi la. I have come face to face with the dustbin. I have lost each and everything today. I have nothing email. I have lost each and everything to this addiction. I have lost the trust, everything, the trust, faith of my parents. I have lost trust of my siblings, all the sisters. I have lost the trust of my ex-wife, everything. I lost whatever I have had. That's why I'm here to tell you this story. That if you are trying to become addict, or if you are already one, it's time to stop this. You cannot stop this, I can guarantee you. You have to get the help. You have to get the help from the rehabilitations. When we reach to the dustbin, we have nowhere to go in. We have very few places to visit. We may visit police station when we steal, when we tell lie, when we cheat people, when we manipulate, that is the place. After that, we may reach hospital when we are at the last stage of liver cirrhosis. And then we visit Heju Lagang, Dutel. That is it. But if you are lucky, a few lucky people, before visiting Heju Lagang, they go to a place called the rehabilitation. I have gone to that place, the rehabilitation. And that is the tale why I have come here today to tell. Let me tell you, lucky people go to the rehabilitation, but all the lucky people are not lucky enough to remain there. Only the luckiest of the lucky people could stop and become a recoverer. Not all the people could recover. Again, they come back. They relapse. So now you knew most of the story out of my life. Most of the story. But there is saying called Dzogpe Sanje Shenpen Semle Thung. The enlightenment is born inside your mind the moment you help others. Please try to help people like us also. We are also the others. I would like to request all the viewers to please stop stigmatizing us and discriminating us. Your stigma, your discrimination against us are killing more than the actual drinking. Because discriminating us, even you are not giving us the job, whatever the job it is, the job opportunities, you don't give us a chance to grow. That's how we go back to the drinking and then we die. I followed the same formula. And today my status is I'm single. I'm jobless. I'm homeless. And I'm volunteering to this CSO called Chithen Fende Association. I have been doing that. I have come face to face with the dustbin. When I reached that face to face with the dustbin, then only my ex-wife, she, with a very slim hope that I could become a human being again, she took me to the rehabilitations. Today I'm clinging to that very slim hope of my ex-wife, and I'm recovering. For now, running 4 years now, I have never touched that substance. Today I have to thank her. Thank my ex-wife for doing that. Whatever I am today, it is because she did it for me. Thank you very much, my ex, if you are watching. I owe you everything. You have done everything for me. I am sorry, please forgive. I have broken your hopes and dreams again and again and again. Please forgive me today. I thought I knew everything about addiction before I went to the rehabilitation. But when I reached to the rehabilitation, I actually knew nothing about this addiction. Nothing. Today I know what the addiction is. I even thought when I was officer, Dashubi Devang, I even thought the wrong thing about this addiction to the soldiers under me. But later I had an opportunity to go back and correct my mistakes and tell those soldiers that I was wrong. We addicts are 7 times more sensitive than the normal human beings. That's why we react more. That's why we are agitated every time. That's why we are more violent. Please bear with us. Next time you see the addicts, next time you see a drunkard shouting in the street, please change your thoughts. So far, when you see that addict shouting on the road, when you see that alcoholics shouting, sleeping on the road, what do you think? Suddenly you think, oh, ni tana shibdi, a chance di darunani de du. Ay gumache mi, au gumi. This is what you thought, gundadi. We are not that. We are sick. Next time you see these people on the street, but please don't go near them. I will never suggest you to go near them because they are the addicts. Don't go near them. Only the thing you have to do is now change your thoughts. The moment you see them, just think, oh, nishi yemi michi yime mu. Anim ji change be nana. Datu sensei, ani nora mano badil, chance tom ji tama shibi yin se. Now chance tom ji, addict tom ji, no samdi, ya, anim midi, nishi yemi michi yime mu, se anim ji, tu sam shi edala. Not only that, please don't keep that inside you. Please teach that value to your children. Your children below age of 9, so that you put it in your child's core value systems. So that when they grow up, we have no problem of stigmatization because they will never stigmatize me if you teach them that way. Now we as a parents, nga chimmi to di phata tani zosha nu wala ani bendi phata jam chi thomil ani apa pha ap sangge gi bus di ani drugs tu me pha am pem gi bum di ani cha thu ne ani we just see them. But did you ever look down to your own kids? When you look at your own kids, they would be the gunda boss of this drinking or a drug network. Now the moment you know that ani al cheragi alu di ani bi me se no chi che gachi be you take it to the room and then you close it there. You dump it in the room. Please don't do that. Nagi gachi bi ne be mo se a da ngi gi never gi mashe ga apsangi gi mashe ga aku gi mashe ga mo. Please don't do that. You send them, immediately send them to the rehabilitation. Nagi Shebiga, you are the last person to know la. Apsange neighbor, they knew it long time back, 3, 4, 5 years back la. So, this is not time to hide la. Immediately send your children to the rehabilitation la. That is the only solution. Please don't keep them. Let me tell you, it's not very easy for me to come here in front of you and to disgrace myself la. And tell you the story and bearing myself. I become vulnerable for attack by everyone. Physical attack, maybe online, any attacks. But still I don't care. Thinking that at least if you, one or two of you in the audience, if you could take home my lessons today, the very purpose of my coming here has been achieved. But I can take the horses only till the river. Whether to drink or not to drink depends upon horses. I cannot force them. But I know we are all mature. Maturity is not when you start speaking big, big things. It is only when you begin to understand small, small things. Please try to understand these small, small things called addiction also. And try to help us and reduce and minimize the stigmatization for people like us. Today, when I came here, I was thrown out of army. I said, yes, I was. But due to the kindness and the magnanimity of His Majesty, the Druk Gelpo, He has given me back my grace. My King has sent me on a pension. Today, I really would like to thank my His Majesty from the bottom of my heart. for doing such an act of kindness. Thank you so much for doing that. I am not the only one. I have so many addicts. Today I stand as the voice for each and every addict in this world for the reduction of stigmatization. Not only that, I'm not only doing for the reduction of stigmatization for the addicts only. I want all the people to understand, even there are people who has a disease like me, those people are being stigmatized more also, like the HIV positives. Please reduce the stigmatization for them also. They are human beings like us. Please minimize the stigmatization for all those LGBTQIs. If you can, please minimize the stigmatization for the sex workers too. We are all the victims of the circumstances. We have never planned to become that. But we became that, what to do? So as a whole human being, please reduce that stigmatization and try to help us, please. If my story has touched you today, please don't keep that story within you. Share my story to inspire others. Please do that. Thank you for listening to my stupid story.